Well, hello again, and welcome to our Kidz at NBC spot. Now, I hope you're finding this helpful, whether you're watching it on Friday afternoon or whenever it is that you are watching it. I hope that it's helpful as we learn more about Jesus. So we're continuing about who is Jesus. All right, and today we're looking at how Jesus is sinless. Okay, so to help us start thinking about that, GP, let's call on GP to come on in. Come on in, GP. Hello, hello, hello. Hi, how you going? Good, good. Yes, thumbs up. Oh, that's right, you got no thumbs. Okay, all right. Well, we're going to think about how Jesus never sinned. So for our little activity today, can you hold our bag for you? I have a bag of, it's a little bit heavy, was it? Sorry. Yes. Okay, I forget that you've got to know any little fins. All right. So we are thinking about some lovely treats. So it's a bag of treats, not a bag of tricks, because I'm not very good at tricks, but we have a bag of treats, and I'm really good with treats. All right, so what I'm going to do is ask you to turn around and then turn away from the screen. I'm going to bring out something out of our bag of treats. I'm going to describe it. I want to see if you can guess what it is. And then when you turn around, you can see if you guessed right. Okay? All right. So here we go. Turn around. No looking at the screen. All right? Okay. Our first treat that I'm going to describe to you. Okay. This is brown. And it's got like in the middle of it is really like runny, chewy, sort of like a caramel. And it's in the shape of a koala. So, what do you think it might be? Can you guess? Okay, turn around, have a look. This is it. Okay, a caramello koala. That's what it is. All right, is that your favorite treat? Oh, yum, hey. All right, let's put that one down there. Now, turn around again. All right. No peeking, no peeking. All right, our next treat. This one is soft and squishy in your mouth. It's sort of got a bit of a powdery thing on the outside, so sometimes, you know, it gets on your hands when you're eating them. They come in pink and white. Can you guess? All right, turn around, have a look. This is it. Marshmallows. Yes. All right. That's our treat. Oh, you like marshmallows? Yes, GP. All right. Let's see if we got another one in here. Let's see. Okay. Turn around. No peeking. All right. Now, this treat. See if you can guess what this one is. It's sort of crunchy. And it's great to sort of snack on, especially in front of the TV or something. And it comes in all sorts of different flavors. Sometimes chicken. Sometimes sour cream and chives, maybe. But this one is salt and vinegar. What might they be? Turn around, have a look. That's right, salt and vinegar chips. Maybe it's your favourite treat as well. All right, let's see for another one. Okay, turn around. Here we go. Oh, another one in here. All right. Now, this treat, it's brown again. And it's sort of creamy, milky. And it's in the shape of a frog. Can you guess what that is? Okay, turn around, have a look. It's Freddos, yes. And I particularly like the ones with strawberry in. Yes. You like strawberries too? Yes, good on you, GP. All right, are you ready? Turn around again. No peeking. All right, what about this one? Okay, now this one is really cold in your mouth. And it's creamy, and sometimes we put cookies in there, sometimes maybe choc bits or Smarties, and some syrups like strawberry, caramel, chocolate, they sometimes go on there. Can you guess what it is? Okay, turn around, have a look. It's ice cream. Now I believe this is a ice cream. That's very a big treat for somebody. So there we go. Ice cream. Okay, turn around again. No peeking. Let's see what's in our bag here. We have, all right, no peeking. Ready? I'm going to describe this one. All right, this one, they're sort of long and thin, a bit sugary on the outside, come in different colours, and they're not sweet. They are sour. Okay, turn around, have a look. Sour worms. All right. Yummo. Well, we've got so many great treats here today. All right. I think we have one more in our bag. Yes, we've got one more. Okay. Turn around. Here we go. All right. Now, this treat is sort of softish, spongy. It's got a nice sugary top on it. Sometimes we decorate the top with little sprinkles or something, or sometimes little Smarties. And it comes in like a little case, so they're very quite neat to eat. Can you think what it is? Okay, turn around, have a look. It's a cupcake. Look at that, a little smiley face on top as well. Yum, hey? Very good. Well, let's put that treat down there too. Thank you very much, GP. You can take the treat bag with you if you like. Yes, thank you. All right, see you later. We'll catch you afterwards. Okay, well, we're learning about how Jesus never sinned. But he was tempted. Were you tempted to turn around and have a look to see what treat I was holding rather than just waiting till the end of the clues that I was giving you? Yes, temptation is real, isn't it? Well, we are thinking today about how Jesus was tempted, but he never sinned. All right, so sometimes we may want to be tempted. Like if you were sitting in the room with your favorite treat all by yourself, and then someone said, don't eat that treat. How long do you think it would take you before you would want to eat that treat? Would you open up the packet and sit there going, oh, I shouldn't, but I will. Yeah, so temptation is a real thing for us. So Jesus, as God, could not sin. All right, as God, he could not sin. But Jesus, as a human, he relied on the Holy Spirit to help him and the Word of God and prayer. And we're going to see how he did that. All right, so the Bible tells us that Jesus didn't sin. Let's see, in 2 Corinthians, firstly, chapter 5, verse 21, it says, Christ never sinned, but God treated him as a sinner because he was taking the punishment for our sins. All right, then we've got another verse here. We've got in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 15, it says, Jesus understands every weakness of ours because he was tempted in every way that we are, but he did not sin. So he was tempted in all the ways that we are. He knows what it's like to be tempted, but he did not sin. Okay, and in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 22, it says, Christ did not sin or ever tell a lie. Wow, so the Bible tells us that Jesus did not sin. But the Bible also tells us, particularly in Luke chapter 4, if you want to go to Luke chapter 4 and read about it, that's a time when Jesus was tempted. He was out into the desert and he was hungry and he was thirsty, and the devil tempted him, but he never gave in to those temptations. And he, particularly when he was being tempted, he used the Bible. Every time when Jesus was tempted, he answered the temptation by saying, the scriptures say. And he would quote what the Bible says. So the Bible was giving him strength. The Holy Spirit was with him, which is what we learned about last week. And then he read the Bible, which showing that it was giving him strength. But also, when Jesus was in the garden of Gethsemane, before he was going to die, and he prayed, so hard, asking God to help him. And Jesus prayed and he says, do what you want, not what I want. So in Luke 22 is where Jesus prays, and he prays to God, and he finds strength in his prayer. So Jesus gives us the example of what we do when we're facing temptation. We are relying on God's Spirit who lives in us. We've got the Word of God, and we pray and we ask for God's help so that we will not sin. So our truth today is from the Bible is that Jesus as God could not sin, but Jesus as a man, he didn't sin. He resisted temptation and he didn't sin. So he never, ever did a wrong thing, not even tell a lie. And why is this important? Well, when we know that we are tempted, we know that Jesus knows what it's like to be tempted because he felt the same things. He knows what it feels like to be tempted. So we should follow Jesus' example by relying on the Holy Spirit, relying on God's word and prayer so that we can not sin as well. All right, and speaking of prayer, our prayer idea for this week. Now, at home you probably have a mirror. Here's a mirror. Okay, so this is one that Erin's small group did. I think they made those at Blast 1 week. They decorated their mirror. Now, if you've got a mirror and you've got some whiteboard markers, you can write on the mirror and it will rub off. So grab a whiteboard marker, and on the mirror, I want you to write three letters. All right, I want you to write a T. So you've got a T, and that's the T stands for thank you. So I want to get you to think about the things that you can thank God for. Then I want you to write S on the mirror, and I want you to, that helps us to remember about the things that we need to say sorry to God for, things maybe even when we tell a lie or we give in to temptation. And then a P for please. And the please, we can ask God to help us so that we will not sin. All right, so TSP, you could write it up on your bathroom mirror, on a mirror in your bedroom, and that will help you to remember to pray, and maybe some of the things, what to pray. All right, now it's time for our Guess Who Wheel. So GP, come on in. Here we go. All right, so let me see. Oh, have you got something in your hands there? Let me see, what are you hiding in your hands? Oh, have you got a guess who for our Bible character today? Thank you very much, GP. Let me see, who have you brought in? See if you can guess who it is. Oh, do you remember last week's? Did you remember who last week's was? Oh, it was Thomas. He's the one that was doubting that Jesus had risen from the dead, but he got to see Jesus himself. And he knew. All right, here's our next character. We have some clues for you. All right, first one. My three sons, so he had three sons. I walked with God. 950 candles on my last birthday cake. Well, he lived a very long time, didn't he? Okay, one of my sons was a real ham. Oh, I think that's a bit of a play on words. I built a triple decker over the rainbow. 5 weeks and 5 days of rain. Wow. There's going to be a flood. And I'm the original big boat builder. Oh, do you think you might know who that might be? Yes, I think he did lots of that, building his boat. Okay. All right. So that's who our Bible character is. Now we're going to go to the wheel. So GP, come on over. And let's spin our wheel. Okay, and we'll see if we can guess who some of our leaders are. All right, are you ready to go, GP? Okay, here we go. Woo! Yay! Okay. Well, let's see here. Well, which one would you like us to pick today? We've got this one. It's number six. Okay, here we go. Let's see if you can guess who this leader is. Enjoys singing with actions, wears glasses, drives a small red car, loves to use lots of pictures for Bible storytelling, and is a grandmother of two. Ah, she's in kids' church. All right, it's Helen. Helen Shum. How great is that? All right, now let's go spin again. We better do another spin. Ready? Here we go. All these things that are on our wheel. Woo! Watching it round and round. Don't get dizzy, GP, by watching. All right, let's see. Which one would you like this week? Okay, this one. All right, this one. Number eight. Okay, number eight. We have... All right, here we go. I love basketball and netball. I love music. I'm quite tall. Ooh. I'm still at school. Okay, so one of our younger leaders. Can you guess who it might be? Cassandra, that's right. It's Cassandra on our blast team. All right, let's go again. Let's see if we can have another one here. Ooh, round and round it goes. Ready? Okay, which one this time, GP? This one. Number 12. Let's see. Here we go. All right, I play basketball. I have three dogs. I work at Caring Bar. I don't like snakes. Ooh, that could be me. Maybe you too, GP. It's Sue. Sue Robinson from Kids Church. Okay. Say hi, Sue. Yes. All right. I think we better do another one. Yes, are you ready? Ready to go. Ooh, okay. Can you pick another one for us? Okay, this one's number 13. All right, here we go. Are you ready for some clues? I'm left-handed. I have two older brothers and one younger sister. I work in a hospital. I have brown hair. I speak two languages. Can you guess who it is? It's Nadine. Yes, Nadine from Kids Church. So big hi to Nadine as well. All right, well, thank you, GP. I think we might leave it there. And we'll be able to do our ISO shake, hey? Let's do that. All right, well, you better come around the front here. We'll put that out the way there. Are you ready? Ready to do our ISO shake? All right, here we go. Flip is going, get your fins ready. Great job, GP. Thank you very much. Okay, guys. Well, that's it for another week, and we look forward to catching you next week. Okay, bye.